Hello friends, today's discussion is about polynomial division using long division method. So in this video we will learn how to find the quotient and the remainder when a polynomial is divided by another polynomial. So after watching this video we will able to solve these types of questions. As you can see here, a polynomial f of x is divided by a polynomial g of x. So it can be p of x, q of x, like that. So a polynomial will be divided by another polynomial. We will find the quotient and the remainder. So like this, we will solve three questions where we have a polynomial like f of x is x cube plus 4x squared minus 3x plus 10 will be divided by g of x. So that is another polynomial, x plus 4. So like that, we will see some questions. Before going to that, let's learn some basics about polynomial division. We know polynomial consists of variables and constants. So whenever we are dividing any polynomial by another polynomial, variables will be divided by variables, constants will be divided by constants. So let's see some basic rules while dividing. So when we go for variables, suppose we have a variable x to the power of 3 and we are dividing it by x to the power of 2. So here we will be using the exponent laws. Here x to the power of 3 by x to the power of 2 will get x to the power of 3 minus 2, that is x to the power of 1. So that means if we divide x cubed by x squared, we will get x. Suppose x to the power of 5 is there and we are dividing by x to the power of 2. So we will get x to the power of 5 minus 2, that is x to the power of 3. So this is the quotient law in exponents. So the same rules we will use it here. So this is like, it can be, suppose x into how much, we will get x to the power of 4. So what we can put here, now since x means x to the power of 1. So here we are using the product law. So x to the power of 1 into how much will do, so that the power of x becomes 4 now. So here already 1 is there. So 1 plus 3 will get 4. So here we'll put x to the power of 3, that is x to the power of 4 now. So x to the power of 1 into x to the power of 3 will get x to the power of 4. So these two things are very much important while doing the polynomial division. Next, now as discuss constant, we will divide by constant. So suppose we have a constant 6, we are dividing by 3, we will get 2. That is obvious. In some cases there will be a fraction divided by a whole number also. Like suppose we have 7 divided by, suppose we have 7 by 2 divide whole divided by 3. In this case what we will do? So 7 by 2 by 3, so 3 can be written as 3 by 1. So in this one there is a shortcut, this 2, the denominator will be multiplied down. So we will get now, so 2 will be multiplied with 3. So we get 7 by 6. This is the rule you have to follow. This is like 7 by 2 divided by 3. So 7 by 2 multiplied by reciprocal of 3 is 1 by 3. So we will get 7 by 6. So instead of doing all this, just bring this denominator down. So we can get a question like 7 by 2 by 3 also. So here in the case also, remember, here again the denominator will be shifted up. Here the denominator shifted down, here the denominator will be shifted up. So this becomes now 7 into 3 by 2. So that is 21 by 2. So this one you have to remember. So how to solve when a fraction is given in a fraction? So when a fraction is divided by a whole number, or a whole number is divided by a fraction, we can use this short rules. Now similarly, we will get a situation like in the variables. Suppose x to the power 2, that is x squared, is multiplied with x plus 1. So in this case what we do, x squared into x plus 1. So x squared into x becomes x to the power of 3. X squared into x, that is x to the power of 3, plus x squared into 1 becomes x squared. So you have to remember, this x squared, when is multiplied to the total polynomial, it has to be multiplied everything whatever is present inside. So this one we have to remember while we are doing the division. One more concept that will be needed while doing polynomial division is the subtraction of polynomials. So what here we have to do, suppose we are having two polynomials, 3x squared minus 7x plus 5, and we want to subtract 2x squared plus 5x minus 3. So here this one will be written in the column method. So plus 5, so 2x squared plus 5x minus 3. Now I want to subtract these two. So this polynomial will be subtracted from this polynomial. So here what you have to do, whenever you are subtracting, remember whenever you are subtracting, all the sign will be changed because we are multiplying this negative sign. So minus of 2, so this is minus 2, minus of plus becomes minus, minus of minus becomes plus. So now we will use these signs, that one we have obtained after multiplying this sign. So now we have 3x squared minus 2x squared, and here we have minus 7x minus 5x, similarly plus 5 plus 3. So these sign we will consider. So 3 minus 2 will get 1, so 1x squared minus 7 minus 5. So here there is a role of integers now. So minus 7 and minus 5, we get minus 12x. Again plus 5 plus 3 will get 8. So this is the way we do the subtraction of polynomials. So this will be very much used while doing the division. So let's start this example. We have x to the power of 3 plus 4x squared minus 3x plus 10 being divided by x plus 4. As it is being divided by x plus 4, so x plus 4 is the divisor, and the polynomial given x cubed plus 4x squared minus 3x plus 10 is the dividend. So here first thing you have to see whether the given polynomial, that's the dividend, is in the decreasing order of the power or not. That means here you can see the power of x, the variable is 3, here it is 2, here it is 1, here it is 0. So it is in the decreasing order. If it is not in the decreasing order, you have to change it into decreasing order, then only start the division. Fine. The same thing for the divisor also. Suppose we have 4 plus x, so we will write down x plus 4 with the decreasing order of the power. So let's start. So while we are dividing, first thing you have to see is the first terms of the polynomials. Here we have x and here we have x to the power of 3. So the first step is x into how much you will do so that we will get x to the power of 3. So how we'll know that? When we divide x to the power of 3 by x. So let's start. So x to the power of 3 by x, how much we'll get? We'll get, see here, x is nothing but x to the power of 1. So x to the power of 3 by x to the power of 1, we'll get x to the power of 3 minus 1, that is 2. So that means if I multiply x into x to the power of 2, I will get x to the power of 3. So here we'll put x to the power of 2. So you can see here x into x to the power of 2, we will get x to the power of 3. Now the thing is, we have another term here, that means the total x plus 4 is to be multiplied with x squared. So x squared into x, we have got x cubed. Similarly, x squared into 4 or 4 into x squared. So we will get 4x squared. Now the multiplication is done. After multiplying, we have to subtract. So as you have seen earlier, so when we subtract, the sign we will change. So x cubed becomes now minus x cubed plus 4x squared becomes now minus 4x squared. Then we will subtract. So x cubed and minus x cubed, they get cancelled. Similarly, plus 4 and minus 4x squared. So 4x squared minus 4x squared gets cancelled. So nothing is left out, the remainder is 0 now. Next thing is to bring all these terms down. The way we are doing the normal division of numbers, the same thing here also. So we have now minus 3x plus 10. Now we'll repeat the same process. See the first term. Here the first term is minus 3x. And here we have x. So x into how much we will do, so that we'll get minus 3x. What in the x? X means it is 1x. So 1 into how much we will do, so that we'll get minus 3. So 1 into minus 3 is minus 3. You have x. So minus 3 into x will get minus 3x. First thing is, you have to match the first term. If the first term matches, then we can continue. Then we have plus 4 into minus 3, because the total x plus 4 is to be multiplied. So x into minus 3 becomes minus 3x, plus 4 into minus 3 becomes minus 12. Then we'll start subtracting. So this minus becomes plus, this minus becomes plus. So minus 3x, now plus 3x gets cancelled. Plus 10 and plus 12 becomes plus 22. So we have, the quotient is x squared minus 3 and the remainder is 22. That means when we divide x cubed plus 4x squared minus 3x plus 10 by x plus 4, we will get the quotient as x squared minus 3 and the remainder will get is 22. Let's see the second example now. So here we have to divide 2x cubed minus 3x squared minus 17x plus 30 by x minus 2. So the dividend is 2x cubed minus 3x squared minus 17x plus 30. So it is in the decreasing order of the powers. So it is correct. The same thing, the divisor is x minus 2. It is also in the decreasing order of the powers. So we can start. So as we have done in the earlier one, here just we'll compare the first terms of the both the polynomials. Here we have x, here we have 2x cubed. So you have to see x into how much I will do, so that we'll get 2x to the power of 3. So remember, number with number, variable with variable. Here x, there is nothing in front of x, that means the coefficient of x is 1. So 1 into how much will be 2? The first thing is 1 2's are 2. Next, x is there. X into how much you will get x to the power of 3. So we can get it, just divide x to the power of 3 by x, we will get x to the power of 2. 3 minus 1, 2. So here just put x to the power of 2. Now it is clear, x into 2x squared. So we can check it also. Suppose I multiply 2x squared with x, I get 2x to the power of 3. So just put here 2 into x to the power of 3. Now as you are multiplying this term with the total polynomial, the divisor, so minus 2 into 2x squared. So minus 2 multiplied by 2x squared. Remember, again number with number. So minus 2 into 2 becomes minus 4, x squared remains x squared. So we get here minus 4x squared. So the multiplication part is over. Next, we have to subtract. Now same thing, while subtracting, what you have to do? Change the signs. So 2 will become now here minus, and this minus will become now plus. After that, cancellation, 2x cubed minus 2x cubed gets cancelled. Then we have minus 3 plus 4. So minus 3x squared and plus 4x squared. Here we will use the integer rule. So minus 3 plus 4 will get plus 1. X squared is there. So only x squared we can write. That is 4x squared minus 3x squared. So we get only x squared. So remainder we have got. After that, whatever is left out, we have to bring it down. So we have minus 17x and 30. We'll proceed the same way. See the first term. Here we have x. Here we have x squared. So x into how much is x squared? So we can say x into x is x squared. X into x is x squared. We have got the first term. We have to just match the first term. After that, we will get it automatically. So minus 2 into x will get minus 2x. Multiplication part done. Now subtraction. So here there is no sign, that means it is plus. So it becomes minus. This is minus, it becomes plus, because we are subtracted. Next, x squared and this minus x squared gets cancelled. Now we have minus 17x and plus 2x. Minus 17 plus 2, we get minus 15x plus 30 will be brought down. Third step, again here we have x, here we have minus 15x. So x into how much we can do? X into minus 15, because x has nothing in front, that means there is 1. So 1 into minus 15 is minus 15, x into 1 is x. So we have minus 15x. So we can simply say minus 15 into x becomes minus 15x. So again we have to multiply with this minus 2 also. So minus 15 into minus 2 becomes plus 30. This one you have to not forget to multiply with the divisor. So whenever we are multiplying any term here, it has to multiply with all the terms in the divisor. Then we get again, so multiplication part is done. Then we have to subtract. So minus 15x becomes now plus 15x plus 30 becomes minus 30. Now we can cancel 30 minus 30. So the remainder is 0. So here you can see it is exactly divisible. So the quotient is 2x squared plus x minus 15 and the remainder is here 0. So on dividing, we will get this as the quotient and remainder as 0. Let's move on to the third example now. So we have x to the power of 4 minus 3x squared plus 4 divided by x minus 1. So the dividend is x to the power of 4 minus 3x squared plus 4. So it is in the decreasing order. So first 4, then 2, then we have no power of x. So same thing with the divisor, we have x minus 1. This is also in the decreasing order of the power. This is the first thing you have to notice. So let's start dividing now. So we have to just consider the first terms, remember here. So here we have x, here we have x to the power of 4. So x into how much will be x to the power of 4? So we can just do the reverse. So x to the power of 4 divided by x we will do. So this can be written as 4 minus 1, we will get x to the power of 3. That means x into x to the power of 3 will give you x to the power of 4. So the first term is matching. Next, we have minus 1 here. So minus 1 into x cube will get minus x to the power of 3. That is minus x cubed. Now I have to subtract. So here there is no sign, so it becomes minus. Here it is minus, so it becomes plus. So x to the power of 4 minus x to the power of 4 gets cancelled. Now coming on to the next terms, here we can find, here the power of x is 2 and here the power of x is 3. Now there is, we cannot subtract this because they are not like terms. Remember, we can subtract only like terms. We have learnt in algebra. So we can subtract only like terms. Here x to the power of 2 and x to the power of 3 we cannot subtract. So we will just bring it down as it is. So what we'll get? We have x to the power of 3, that is plus. So x to the power of 3. Then we have minus 3x squared. It is not subtracted. So we will bring it down. Plus 4 is there. Next. So we have got it. The next step again. Here x is there. We have x to the power of 3 here. So x into x to the power of 2. That is x squared. So x into x squared is x to the power of 3. First term is matching. Then let's see the next ones. So minus 1 into x squared. So minus into plus. Minus 1 into x squared. X squared. Now we can again subtract. So this becomes minus. Minus becomes plus now. Now we can cancel x cubed and x cubed. Again we have like terms. Minus 3x squared plus x squared. Minus 3. There is nothing. So we can write it as a 1. So minus 3 plus 1 becomes minus 2x squared. Then 4, just bring it down. So we have now minus 2x squared plus 4. Moving on to the next step now. Here we have x and here we have minus 2x squared. So here there is no number part in front of x. That means it is 1. So to get minus 2x squared, so we will just divide minus 2x squared by x. So when we divide minus 2 by, nothing is there, so it is 1. So minus 2 by 1 is minus 2. X squared by x is only x. That means we have to write here minus 2x. So x into minus 2x will give you minus 2x squared. So x into x is x squared. 1 into minus 2 is minus 2. So we will get here minus 2x squared. Next, minus 1 into minus 2x. So minus 1 into minus 2 becomes plus 2. Nothing is there to multiply, so we'll just put here x. That means minus 1 into minus 2x will give you plus 2x. Then we'll subtract. So minus becomes plus, this plus becomes minus. Then we can cancel these two. But here again the same thing, here we have a constant, here we have variable, we cannot subtract. So we'll bring it as it is down, all the terms. So minus 2x and plus 4. Now let's see, that's the last step now. So as we are having here x and here we are having minus 2x. So x into how much will be minus 2x. So x into minus 2 will be minus 2x, or else we can do it like this, minus 2x by x, reverse. So minus 2x by x will get minus 2. So that is the required thing in the quotient part. So minus 2, if I write here, you can see here x into minus 2 becomes minus 2x. Again, minus 1 into minus 2 becomes plus 2. Let's see. So minus becomes plus on subtraction, plus becomes minus. So this gets cancelled. 4 minus 2 is 2. So here the quotient is x to the power of 3, that is x cubed, plus x squared minus 2x minus 2, and the remainder is 2. So in this way we can divide any polynomial by another polynomial. So just you have to remember two things here. One is multiplication of polynomials and another one is subtraction of polynomials. Thank you and keep exploring.